Hi all, in this video, let's learn about how to debug the HTML code, how to identify and fix the errors in HTML. So let's start with the point by point. There is something theory to be discussed here. So let me try to explain you how the browser understands the HTML code and all these things. So unlike other programming languages like Java and REST, HTML is no need to compile into different form. So the browser parses it and shows the result. That's it. It is interpreted, not compiled. HTML is not compiled. It is only interpreted. Usually we will be having two types of errors. Number one is syntactical error. Number two is logical error. Syntactical error is like we are breaking the rules of the programming language. So there will be getting the syntactical error. And the logical errors are like we'll be writing some logic error. So something we'll be expecting the output and we'll be writing some logical error. So that comes under the logical errors. But if we want to discuss about the HTML, HTML will not suffer from the syntactical errors because browser parses this code with the permissively. So what does it exactly means? If there are any syntactical errors in the HTML page as well, browser will load that page with those errors as well. So, and it browser will try to fix those errors. Browser will consist of some inbuilt rules. If there is some markup which is incorrectly written in the HTML, browser tries to fix those errors because a browser has some inbuilt rules to fix those errors of the HTML page. So why the HTML page is designed in this way is because at the earlier stages, the web development and parsing the content into the browser is a big challenge. So that's the reason they have not concentrated strictly about the syntactical errors. The thought of just loading the content and publishing the HTML pages is at the time is a big challenge. So they did not kept any strict rules regarding the syntax. That's the reason HTML is parsed and directly shown into the browser page, even if it has syntactical errors as well. So now let's see this page. This page is intentionally kept some errors. So for example, you wrote one p tag and we have not closed this p tag. Also we wrote this li list tag and we have not closed this li list tag. So also we have wrote this strong tag and we have not closed this strong tag. Also we have improperly nested this strong and em tags. So we have started the strong tag here. We have ended it here. In middle, we have opened em tag and we have closed it after the strong tag. So in short, this is a incorrectly nested thing. Okay, so there are a couple of errors. Like if you see in the third li element, the href doesn't consist of the double quotes. We have missed the double quotes. As I said, this is intentionally kept some errors. Let's see how the browser has fixed these errors. So this is all the errors we thought. One is not properly closing the end tags. And one is forgetting about the end tags. And another one is improperly keeping the nested items. And another one is href double quotes is missing. So these are the four things. And let's see how the browser treats these things. So this is how it treats. So let's inspect this and let's see how browser tried to fix these errors. So if you see, the p tag was automatically added. Browser fixed this p tag and ending tag. So not only for the paragraph tag, it was added to all the list items. This is because before starting any of the tag, it tried to close the tag with the p tag or with li tag. So browser has fixed this closing tags by itself. This works not only in the Chrome, in all the modern browsers also, browser does the same thing. So this is about the first thing. And coming to the second point, we have kept the strong. At this point, we kept the strong tag and we have not closed it throughout the document. So that's the reason browser, he is not sure where to end this strong tag. So that's the reason it has given every text into the strong bold. So that's the reason you got this strong characters text toward the document. So second point, it was not sure. So it was applied this strong tag to enter document. And coming to the third point, we have nested wrongly. I mean, we used strong and inside that we have used em. And inside that we have used some, see like this. We have used strong and em strong. So how the browser has resolved this means, so firstly it has taken this badly nested elements. How does a browser resolve it means, so it has started with the strong tag and we have ended this here. So this is fine for the browser, but in between you have started this em tag but you did not ended it. So that's the reason browser has ended it at this point. So in sense it has kept one em tag here, so like this. Now also you have not started em tag but you are ending this em tag, so that's the reason browser has automatically fixed this tags like this. So it kept like this, so it was added an em tag like this. So this is what the browser did both for the ems here and there. So browser has automatically fixed this incorrectly nested elements as well. Coming to the fourth issue, the double quotes issue. So here we have missed the double quotes. So what does the browser do? It means it has just ignored it. It was not displayed at all. The anchor tag was not displayed. This is because we have missed that href double quotes. So this is how the browser tried to fix our errors. So it does not, unlike other programming languages, if you do any of the error in the React.js or Angular.js frameworks, so the page would be broken. It will not show any of the things. It will directly broke the page and it will show the exact error. But HTML doesn't, it will not do like that. It will, browser will parse that HTML and it will try to fix the errors as much as it can. If not, it will render as it is. So that is how the browser parses the HTML. So what if you have a small file so you can understand what all the errors you have done? So fine, that's fine. But what if you have a huge lines of code, HTML, how you need to validate them? So just copy this code, your HTML code, and this is the W3 validator. It validates the HTML code. Now here you can just give the URI address. You can upload the code or you can directly paste the code. So just I'm pasting the HTML code. If your code has huge number of lines, it's not possible to check one by one line like what we have done now. So that's the reason you can copy paste here. And if you click check, so this is W3 validator URL. So this validates entire our HTML and it will give line by line warnings and errors. So here you can see error and tag li implied, but there were open elements. So it is saying that we have missed the li tag at the 15th line. It will give the line numbers and it will ask us to fix these errors. So these are the below errors. Few errors were automatically fixed by the browser, but we should not leave that browser will fix these errors, and we should not depend upon browser. Each browser behaves in a different way. So we can't say that exact this HTML may work in Chrome, but the same may not work in IE or another browsers. So that's the reason it's a good idea to validate our HTML content. And if there are any errors, it's good idea to ourselves to fix those errors by checking these things. So this is about this W3 validator. If you want to do the same in your code itself, like you are coding in a Visual Studio, you wanted to have the same validator in your code, then go to the extensions here. So in the Visual Studios at the left side, you will be have extensions. So click this extensions and type HTML hint here and click the first one. So HTML hint, you need to install this extension to the VS Code, and this will work in as the same as a validator which we have seen. So if you see, yeah, I will minimize this. So you can see this will work as the same. You can see the value. It will give the errors like this as the same validator what the online validator has does. It will give the same errors. So it's good idea to add this HTML hint extension to your VS Code so that it will validate our HTML code as well. So this is all about how to debug the HTML issues and how to identify the issues, how the browser parses this HTML code. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.